over now.
Yo, YouTube, what's going down? It's your boy Potsy, and today I'm bringing you some WWE 2K15. Don't worry about that. It's just a little backdrop. I want to talk about WWE NXT R Evolution. It was so sick. As you see in the background, we got Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn right here. I guess the pay-per-view, I guess that's like their own pay-per-view, was phenomenal. It was so fun to watch. I never get really hyped up, you know, with pay-per-views as much. When NXT comes out, it is so, so good to watch. This is why I enjoy wrestling so much, because you see these guys, these young guys, and they are just tearing the house down. It is so cool. And also, I'm just going to kick it off with pretty much, I just want to talk real quick about everything, because it's just something I really want to do right now. Started off with Corey Graves announcing his retirement. If you don't know who Corey Graves is, he was a really good superstar, and he had a lot of injuries with his neck and all that stuff, concussions, so he had to stop wrestling. But which now WWE gave him a commentator spot, so they always find something for superstars that are hurt to work around with the WWE. But though, the first match was the debut of what's on your screen, Kevin Owens, Kevin Steen. Oh my god, dude. Oh, the pop that he had was so good. The crowd just was on fire when he came out. I was marking out, jumping up and down, just flipping out. And then he faced the Moonchild, CJ Parker, which we know is pretty much going to be a squash match, which it really wasn't actually. Kevin Owens had his little momentum, and it slowed down a little bit, and he got rocked in the face and broke his nose. He was busted up pretty bad as I burp, and then he came and hit the powerbomb, and dude, it was just phenomenal. His debut was really good, and I already bought his t-shirt, so I'm expecting that to come in probably, I think, right after Christmas, so it is what it is. And then we got the Lucha Dragons versus the Von Villains. It was a pretty good standard tag team match. He always had Lucha Dragons, a high flying. It was pretty good. I really enjoyed it, as well as the Lucha Dragons retained the title. So it was fun. I enjoyed the match. It was really good, very good actually. And then I'm really just going on top of my head. I hope I'm going in order. It was like Baron Corbin, Corbin facing like Ty Dillinger. It was a quick squash match. The fans were chanting how long they count. But the count died when it like passed 30, because usually his matches are squash matches and they're fast, like 13 seconds to 10 seconds. In the middle of the match, Bull Dempsey was staring him down. So most likely those guys are gonna have a little feud going, which is pretty cool. I like to see Bull Dempsey, especially that little guy. He's like pretty much from Brooklyn, New York, and he's kind of like their version of Taz. He has that mind, like, he just wants to beat the crap out of you and pretty much break your neck. And then also, the match that I was looking forward to as well, one of my, pretty much straight down overall I was looking forward to, was the Hideo Itami and Finn Balor versus the Ascensions. And that was so sick of a tag team match, especially when Finn Balor finally revealed the face paint that he always does back in the indies. He did a variety of, like, Venom, bunch of, like, I can't think of the names right now, but he did one, he does different characters, of, like, comic books, and it's so cool looking. He does, like, the Punisher and all that. I will put the picture, I'll put the picture up right here, right now. So as you see right there, I get a good look. That's pretty sick, right? And then also, that was a great match, too. A lot of pretty much spots were just flying everywhere. And then you had, Baylor and Hideo Itami. I couldn't even think of the damn name right. Did the double foot stomp on the Ascensions to get the victory. So it was a really cool finish. And then you had the Divas women's title match with Charlotte and Sasha Banks, which I thought was just going to be a typical match. Nope, that didn't go well as planned, because those girls, women, tore the house down as well. This is why when you watch NXT, you're going to get a show. You're going to get a wrestling show, which was phenomenal. These two girls, these two ladies pretty much went, I don't want to say balls to the wall, tits to the wall. I like that. Tits to the wall. That's pretty good. I like that. Tits to the wall. And it was just so good. Like, I'm sorry I keep saying that, but, like, it was fun to watch. I never, like, didn't look away, like, at all during the whole pay-per-view.
As I yawn, I'm a little tired. Oh, excuse me.
Yeah, I didn't yawn. I'm not gonna. I didn't yawn. Of course I yawn. But I didn't like move. I didn't do anything. I just watched it. And so many times during this pay-per-view, they chanted, "This is wrestling," or "Holy shit, this is awesome!" And you, like, repeatedly, you barely get that in a you know, on a pay-per-view in a WWE program, like, you know, like Battleground or, you know, any of those Survivor Series, all type of that stuff. It's like, it'd be like one or two, but like, they kept chanting it. So, I mean, they did the first holy shit chant when Kevin Owens jumped over the top rope, did a front flip. You know, they chanted holy shit there, you know, and it was just like, oh my god, like, we are finally, we're witnessing something that we can watch forever. Like, to be honest, like, I don't watch SmackDown because I'm at work, so I'm, oh, thank God, I really don't care. But, like, on Raw, I'm like, what's the point? What's the point of staying for 3 hours and just BSing, you know? It's annoying. When I can go on NXT, be on for an hour, boom, I can enjoy it, I'm done, you know? So, I mean, that was, you know, the Charlotte and Charlotte Banks was a phenomenal match as well. But the main event that pretty much, quote-unquote, stole the show, if I can say, Sami Zayn, you know, facing Adrian Neville, the NXT champion, and the stipulation was if Sami Zayn lost, he was quitting the WWE, which kind of built, like, you know, people, they want Sami to win, because you don't want to see this guy, you know, just disappear like that. Which, you know, I try to step away becoming reality, you know, the real concept of wrestling and then being a fan. Because being a fan, it's more fun, you know, just be like, oh, well, you know, he's not leaving, you know. It's just like, push away from it. You want to become a fan. That's what's a lot of, you know, a lot of excitement. So, I mean, the match was just, oh, fun. It was beautiful. Like, they saw, like, the first 3 minutes was straight ground attacks and just, you know, feeling each other way, how they can, you know, finally get that, you know, the momentum going, and that went well. There's so many spots, and the, you know, and then, like, one of the spots is, or one of the parts of the match is where the ref got knocked down like twice or something like that, and the crowd chanted, "This ref sucks, this ref sucks." I was cracking up when that happened. And then Adrian Neville brought out the, you know, the belt, and he was about to hit him with it. Sami Zayn saw it, and, you know, he had, you know, the idea of, you know, I'm going to use the belt, you know, and hopefully get the victory, steal a victory. And, you know, the crowd is just saying, please don't do this. You've gone so far. Please don't ruin this. So, but, like, during that whole time, he's looking back and forth, looking at Neville, looking at the ref. He's cursing. Like, they had to mute so many times because they don't want to hear it. He said, but he said, "Get up, you motherfucker. Fuck this," and that's when he dropped the belt. And then, you know, they came back and they had a little spot where it looked like, you know, Neville was about to come in with the victory. He kicked out. Then all of a sudden, you know, Sami Zayn had the momentum. Boom, hit the kick. You know, and then 1, 2, 3, he became champion. It was awesome. That crowd popped. And the first, you know, he's crying. He's, you know, he can't believe it. And he's just cursing out, like, "I'm the fucking man, I'm the man, I'm fully," like, he's just cursing. Then, all you see is Kevin Owens and the rest of the, you know, the rest of the NXT squad coming out, and cheering for him, and then, you know, everyone leaves. Kevin Steen comes back, you know, because they're best friends. He raises his hand, and turns on him. Turns on Sami Zayn. His best friend picks him up and does a power bomb on the apron. And Sami Zayn's head hit a thud. And, like, it just, boom, hit a thud on it. And then Kevin Owens walks away. You see William Regal come down, push him, saying, "What the hell, you know, why'd you do that?" Kevin Steen walks away and leaving the NXT and myself shocked. So, like, I really can't wait for the next week of NXT to get the whole thing, because it's been phenomenal. It was so good. So I hope you guys enjoyed, you know, pretty much the little quick review. Make sure you, like, leave a comment on what you think about the pay-per-view, so we can talk about it. You follow me on Twitter at Potsy Gaming, all that stuff, man. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. So like, comment, subscribe, and I'm on. Peace.